How are you? Let's make sure the phone's off. That's it, I, you know.
Well, good afternoon, everyone. We're extremely happy. if you wonder how happy we are, think how happy you would be if you just won $500 million. That's what we just did. We're extremely proud of all the folks who have worked so hard to get to this point. And believe me, when we heard the results today, it was just the most wonderful feeling. So we're just here to celebrate. And Joel, comments please?
Absolutely. This is huge. This gives us a chance to really jumpstart the revitalization of Rochester and the Finger Lakes region. There are a lot of details we don't know yet. But what we understand is our plan was selected and it will frame how the first $100 million and subsequent awards are made over time. There'll be some state process, we don't quite understand it yet. There'll be announcement of awards in the parallel Regional Economic Development Council process, and those will start to come out and be available to the press very, very soon. The big deal is having worked, it seems like forever, with 450 of the greatest people involved in the work groups, and BCG, and Vinny Esposito, and the Empire State Development crowd, and so many heroes in Wegmans, and University of Rochester, and RIT. We pulled it off. And why did we pull it off? In three words, we were united for success. Nobody should ever forget two aspects of this plan. Every single vote for the past 5 years of the Finger Lakes Regional Economic Development Council has been unanimous. And second, this time, the major change we made in our focus was to not only focus on economic development and job creation, but on poverty eradication. And that is a huge part of this plan. We intend to lift everybody up together.
Fran is taking care of our poverty initiative. She's leading it. And as Joel said, that's why we were able to win this year. It was singled out as a real game changer. Frank, thank you, Frank.
Yeah. And I want to note the other people up here are all heroes. And start with Mark Peterson and Aaron Kress, who were on the scoring committee and just are indefatigable in their efforts. We have Ginny, who basically provided the line on the plate to back. Bill Strasberg, who works at Wegmans, who's been a superhero. Josh Farrellman, who works at the University of Rochester. My friend here, Joe, who's been just as hardworking as everybody else. But this is just a few, again, of 450 people who worked on this project. Let me also note, this was not just private corporations and people throughout the region. It also included Mayor Warren, it included County Executive Brooks, it included political officials from all 9 counties, and they were a vital part of this process.
What this does is enables us to plan out over a 5-year period. The other awards were only for a single year, but this is going to, they've guaranteed us $100 million a year for the next 5 years, and that's great for planning. So we really have something special, and that's why we're so excited.
I married a PhD in statistics, and she taught me that $100 million is 4 times more than the $25 million we were competing for in the previous years. and 5 years is five times more than 1 year. And that gives you a sense. I mean, the magnitudes of what we competed for this year are breathtaking. $500 million compared to $25 million. And so that is why this is so important. But the second part as to why this is so important, as Danny has continuously reminded us, we have a plan. And it's a plan in which we have basically general buy-in from everyone who's affected by it, a plan to carry this region forward. We've had some tough times. This is a chance to really accelerate our progress, turn the trajectory around.
We've got a good crew to answer any questions you might have, so please.
There's so many projects that I know that people would like to see the money spent on. Any idea which ones will be chosen, or can you give us kind of a hint on what's money means to the people out there?
Well, I think the hard work begins today to answer the question of where the money is exactly spent. And what we were asked to do in the plan was not pick particular projects because it does have a 5-year horizon. We were asked to pick what are the strategies, what are the businesses that we want to develop within those strategies that we will continue to vote on over the 5-year period. So we have some projects that were put in the plan originally for the first year, and those certainly will be looked at favorably. But future projects will have to be determined, and that's where we're going to have to roll up our sleeves and answer those questions.
So for people at home, what does this mean to them? Like they're saying, oh my gosh, all this money, how's it going to help me?
I'll tell you how it makes a difference. Among other things we're focusing on is a significant investment in an innovation zone in downtown Rochester. We're focusing on dramatic progress in agriculture and food processing. We're focusing on a poverty initiative. We're focusing on some specific areas such as optics, photonics, and imaging. We're focusing also, though, on our future. And our future, among other things, involves creating new industries and new businesses. And we don't know all the projects we'll be supporting over the next 4 years. We do know our commitment is to create a sustainable, self-sufficient economy.
Any idea when you'll be sitting down with the state trying to iron out those processes that you're not sure about?
There'll be more information later today, we believe, or at least very soon. And we'll be in a position where even we will know more than we know now. The big news, and it cannot be overstated, we won. and so somewhere in Albany, there's a $500 million bank account with the Finger Lakes region's name on it, and that's what we'll be drawing against in the next 5 years.
Is that money going to come through the Economic Development Council?
We'll find out. But the key is it's green and it will arrive.
we're certainly euphoric about winning, but we really have to recognize that we wouldn't be here happy as we are if it hadn't been for the governor who gave us this opportunity. So it's really special what he's doing, and this plan is not his plan, it's the community's plan. And what he did was recognize that the best plan will come from the community. So that's why we're really so excited, and it's why it's a very special plan. And it did involve so many people. And as we were sitting today, wondering whether we would win or lose, I mean, there was a lot of pressure, believe me, because so many people had contributed. And the last thing we wanted to hear was that we lost. I'm glad we weren't one of those groups. But fortunately, we have won. And I do think we have to thank the governor for that. I think it's one of the best programs that's ever existed.
So. You can't thank the governor enough, but you also can't thank the legislature enough, because they voted the money. And so it was a combination of the New York state government, led by Andrew Cuomo, coming together to support a process which unequivocally is to revitalize Upstate. And we're going to work on it.
Can you talk about potential jobs that could be, numbers that could be created? I know that's another big part of this, right?
There'll be thousands, and it'll become clearer as we go forward. But if you look backward at what we've been able to achieve over the last 4 years, as we articulated in the report we just delivered, we've created tens of thousands today, and we're going to have more money now to accelerate that process.
It seems like from the plan that exists right now, a lot of the projects, or at least a lot of the projects you look into, in some way, shape, or form, benefit Eastern Business Park. I mean, they'll be going there in some way or fashion. Can you talk a little bit about, over the next 5 years, how Eastern Business Park will look different and be fun, like some of these projects that you have in mind from the plan?
Well, first of all, I'm really excited that Eastman Business Park appears to be a big part of our future, because we've been pushing that for 4 or 5 years, because it was, in the beginning, a serious problem. Kodak was having problems, and the park looked to us, if we didn't fix it, we had a serious problem on our hands. And we knew if we did fix it, that we'd have a great asset on our hands. So I'm just thrilled that we're finally getting new businesses in there and providing jobs with Eastman Business Park, because it's a great resource. So I'm so happy that we're at that stage today, and we've been fighting this for a long time, it seems. And so I think we've really reached a good point where it's a big asset to our community. So Joel, you might want to answer specific on that.
And let me just take it a little different way. We focused on 3 core industries we wanted to stress and 3 enablers. Eastman Business Park is part of one of the core industries. We're also focusing on the stamp project out in Batavia. We've had an enormous success so far. We're focusing on the innovation zone in that bucket. There are 5 other buckets. So it's a comprehensive plan, and it covers a lot of territory.
You asked, what does this mean to the average person here in our region? And what it means to me is, no matter who I am, I want my children to stay here. And I think we've got great jobs for everyone, whether you're a PhD or whether you're just learning some job skills. That's the wonderful thing about the plan. And I'm confident that people aren't going to have to leave the Finger Lakes region to get a job. They're going to be happy here, and they're going to be challenged here. And I think that's the biggest question. I think it's going to be huge. This may seem a surprise, but just to grow organic grains, one of our partners has needed to spend $50 million on agricultural land, which is huge to me. Well, that concept wasn't being thought about a few years ago. So things are really changing. And then there's a company going in with Eastman Business Park that makes beets, called the Love Beets Company. Well, we're going to, on alternate years, they'll plant beets in those same areas, land areas, so there'll be rotation of crops, and none of these things would have existed before. So it's kind of a new world, and we were actually surprised at all the agriculture that is going to be happening here in the Finger Lakes region. But frankly, many of those jobs aren't high-skilled jobs. They're jobs for people who just want to work and want to do something. And of course, your skills can increase while you're doing them. But that's why we're so thrilled with the various jobs that we have in the region, and we feel really good about it.
Part of this plan was, it is $500 million right now, but part of the plan was to bring in more private investment to kind of even multiply that investment. How does that happen? How do you measure that?
Among the reasons I think we won was we focused on what's called leverage. There's the ratio of private investment to what the state would invest. And we were absolutely rigorous in terms of reaching out to potential firms that might locate here and getting commitments of various sorts and being very analytical about the probability of them succeeding and how much they needed and where they needed it, when they needed it. We probably put together a more detailed plan on leverage than any of the competitive plans. And I know when we made the oral presentation in Albany just a few months ago, that was one of the things we stressed, I think, to a greater extent than the others. There will be not just the $500 million from the state, but there'll be billions in private investment over the next several years. And it's the combination that's going to be transformative. Now, no one should have delusions. I mean, this this is not going to be, you know, peaches and creams and rainbows every day, but we're going to make significant progress, and much more significant progress than we could have without Andrew Cuomo's commitment to this upstate revitalization and the state legislature support.
But that's exciting what Joel said there. It's not just the $500 million. It's the $500 million times 5, 6, maybe 10. So we may be talking $5 billion in total investment. And that's what the $500 million is going to help us get. So it's the private investment that will come because of this $500 million. That's how we're looking at it.
Well, guys, thank you very much. Big day, more news to come.